Welcome back from that beautiful break. You're still watching ABBA TV. The show is Saloon Talk. Guys, if you're not catching up on the show, please go back to all our social media platforms. Put the hashtag Saloon Talk. You're going to catch it up, and you will catch it up later if you've missed it. Guys, we were still talking to the beautiful Lynette. She's still telling us her opinion on this whole thing. Lynette, beautiful lady.
So I was telling you how I came back, like, because I was planning to abort just because of a mere comment, and then I decided to put my anger, my bias, my emotions, my fear on something good. There's a project in the pipeline that is going to be helping all the mothers out there, all the people out there that have been disrespected in the society, just in the name of, oh, you're going to lose your body shape, what, blah, blah, blah. To hell with you people that keep on disrespecting women in such a perspective, because you were born by women. You were raised by women. Women have made it in life. Women have made it in life even after giving birth. So those things should stop. Those things are so 80 years, man. Like, who does that? No one. Biachalo. Biachalo. So, with time, I'll be giving you, when the food is ready, of course, I will serve. But for now, for the ladies out there, man, I'm coming for you. I'm coming to help you. I got you. That's all I can say.
I have a popping question. Let me ask Lisa. Lisa, you're young. Sergio. Lisa, do you have sex?
Of course I do. Well,
you have a boyfriend, right? Like, you're in a committed relationship.
Yeah, I am.
So very many of us know, for those who, like, very many of us, even Lynette herself, before she decided to be pregnant, we have all used contraceptive, we have used birth control pills, we have used, like, different kinds of birth control methods, very many different kinds. So, like, what kinds of methods have you used before? I not only for originals.
Well, end of the day, there are a lot of things that people use, because, like, there are a lot of things. I've actually had friends that use injections, pills.
What is the one they put inside Baba Bakaitach? Because kano Bakaita, akwa mkono Bakaita implant, there is one they push inside your uterus. That's an IUD, yes, an IUD.
So, as opposed to in a committed relationship with a person that, like, with a partner that we agree on certain things, we definitely have our way, how we do our thing. So, well, we have how we handle our things. So, we agree upon certain things on how we are living our life, when are we going to have kids, and yeah. But then, still, as a person in a committed relationship, at the end of the day, if at all it comes up and things don't really work out the way we really work out them, so yeah,
there are very many people who have actually used these birth control methods. They reach and they reach and they don't work.
Yeah,
one and that's all actually, like, pills, but they reach a point
I've
that they
had
don't
friends,
work.
I've had friends that have used, are they injections, something like
yeah,
that?
Injections, yeah, that numb your hormones.
And then because I'm a person that has been actually older friends, so I've had friends that have been using that before me, and I've seen them, like, I've seen what has happened to them. They've gotten to a point where they won't even give birth, and it's a bit hard. Because anyway, those things are a bit effective in your body. It doesn't, yeah, end of the day, as you can take a drug, it's effective. If at all you're going to take a painkiller, it's going to heal your headache, yeah. But end of the day, if you take more of it, there's always a danger. So they have really had a lot of issues with that.
I had a friend of mine, those things. Obviously, not every woman is ready to have a kid, but doesn't mean they don't want them. So I pushed this friend of mine, and she checked. The mama gamba. She reached a point, she took too many pills to the point that they started collecting up somewhere in her uterus. So they had to go operate and it was a jam. The mama gamba, she has even killed her chances of having kids. So, like, there are people that actually, there are women that use contraceptives, but they overuse it. Like, never chukola new, because they, most of them, majority, they be jumping from man to man to man to man to man. Like, before you decided to have a baby, I know you've been having sex with your partner, and, like, what type of birth control methods were you using?
Before I actually get to the point of telling you what I was using, this thing should not apply to you. Let us stop blaming the ladies for overusing them. Because you cannot have sex.
Yeah, but
sex is between two people, right?
Yes,
it is done by
yes.
two people. So why are we pinpointing the girls that, hey, she used drugs, or she used pills, what. It is the men that make us do these things.
Hey, before we go anywhere, do men also have things that make them stop?
They do not, because society made it, men are just supposed to enjoy
and
live.
I know.
But I want to tell all the girls out there, let us stop giving these men authorities. At the end of it all, it is your future you're ruining. It is your life you are ruining. By the time you start using these contraceptives more than once, and a man is not even affecting anything in his life, you reach a point in life where you want to settle and have your beautiful kids, your good family, and you cannot because you burnt all your eggs. So let's put it on men. If you're not ready to marry me, if you are not ready to do these things, we should stop doing wifey materials to these boyfriend things. This boyfriend materials, sis Maravich. I don't even know how to call them.
We're not even taking you anywhere.
We're not even taking you anywhere, and you are sacrificing your entire life for these poor boys.
So very many girls, Barbie, she ends up she finds herself in a situation whereby, okay, now I'm with this boy, I'm with this guy, or okay, yes, he has told me that he loves me, and now we are now I'm pregnant. Now what? Obviously, the guy has not given you an option. Ahogambe and say, the second I'm not going to take care of the kid. So that is how very many, this is the point. Very many girls out there, they want to actually have kids. Having kids doesn't necessarily mean, I have to have a plan, I need to first get married, or I need to be 25, I need to be this age. Like, there are some girls, according to how they were raised, and I know you can vouch me on this, very many girls these days, most of Katiababele, Kampala, hustlers, they've grown up in disabled homes, most of them grew up with single moms, so very many of them have this thing of, okay, fine, if at all I end up getting pregnant, if something goes wrong and I end up getting pregnant, I would decide to have this kid because I know I'm hardworking. I'm going to go and I work and I prepare for my kid. And even if I'm alone, I'll do that. But then now, Ogambi Omusaji Adiributo, the guy hasn't even sat down with you to discuss. Akugambi de, I don't want this kid. I'm not going to take care of this kid. And you're like, bro, when we were in this thing together, yeah,
that drives me back to who you are dating. Do not get excited and start dating everyone just because a man has I'm just giving an example, I'm not trying to be a racist, just because a man is light skinned, manya, he does this, you should really take time. That is why I emphasize these things of courtship. People misunderstand the term courtship. Before you know it, it's just 1 week, you're already sleeping with a man. Before you know him, before you know what he does, before you know. And the other thing, sex is spiritual. That's what girls out there do not know. Sex is so, so spiritual. When I have sex with you, we're going to share a lot of spiritual things you don't even know. And why never you are? Yeah, so girls should be so, so careful on who they date before they even start using those drugs and everything. Because at the end of it all, it is your life you are ruining.
But you can still accept the fact that men are very good actors. Actually, men, he studies the character of a woman. I'm sorry, it's again against him, but because the chick has a bum, has hips, she's light skinned. Yes, that attracts them. But when he comes to talk to you,
Are you dating?
Yes, currently, yes. Yes, I am dating. I won't lie, because if I lie, I'm the host of the show. Yes, I am dating.
And if you are to rate your relationship, how would you rate it on a scale of 10? On a scale of 10.
honestly speaking, I've been with this person for a couple of months now. And yes, I will not say I don't love him.
We've been together yet?
Yes, we are living together apparently.
A couple of months and you moved in with a man already?
Don't judge me.
I'm not judging.
Well, okay, like I said, everybody has reasons to why they do things. I won't go into details of my reasons, but I had a reason why I moved in with him. And also, like I said, I won't say I don't love him. I love him. I don't know what, but I do love him. Because you cannot be with someone and you've decided to be with them. But then, every relationship has issues. Every relationship has that type of person who is quiet, that type of person who needs a lot, that type of person who's too needy, the other one who gives you the need you need. So every relationship has these different circumstances. And according to mine, Yes, it is. It's not perfect, but it's also not bad. It's where.
So when are you guys planning to have kids? And at the moment, what are you guys using?
Apparently, at some.
Yes, you've been asking. We also want.
I love. Honestly, my ears are gonna cut now. Okay. No, we're not planning on having any kids. He's not planning on having any kids. Me, I am. Maybe in the future. I want to have a family, honestly speaking. Like I said, I won't lie. I grew up with a single mom. And she wasn't perfect, but she was my mom. And she was there for me. She didn't give up on me. Other parents would give up on you, walk on a good street, you know? So I actually appreciate for her, like what she did. But like staying with her, being a single mom, things weren't easy. Things were hard. I had to help her out with everything. So me, sometimes I want to hang out, so oh, yeah, you're young, but you don't think like a person your age. Me, honestly speaking, I want to get married. I want to have kids at the right time. Right now, I'm not there.
But you're married, I might say.
I'm not married.
Because by the time you cohabit with someone, do you know the meaning of cohabiting with someone? By the time you cohabit with someone, I mean, that's marriage. In Uganda, it is called kaundo kakumita.
Yeah, but you've also heard of this saying that you don't know your tomorrow, right? And you also do not, you do not know when the things that you are supposed to get when they come. They mean to be jabuzi, like the will of God. So yes, we are staying together. It's a committed relationship. I love him, he loves me.
Has he seen your parents yet? Your family yet?
Next to my work. Oh God. Anyway, beautiful people, the conversation is still running. Like I said, go down to our social media platforms and put the hashtag SaloonTalk. You are gonna get the information. And if you want us to hear your point of view, please put it down. Let us go for a short commercial break. When we come back, the conversation is still running.